Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Hey everybody, this is Reid. Today I'm going to be playing a 4-round sealed deck daily event. It's Dragons of Tarkir and Fate Reforged. now, this is a challenging format because you still have the remnants of the gold theme that was in Khans of Tarkir, but you get far, far, far fewer mana fixers or dual lands in your sealed pool. So it's difficult to balance the temptation to want to branch into different colors for powerful gold cards, and the restrictions put on you by having to play so many basic lands. Well, let's take a look at the sealed pool that I'm given here. Remember, it's 4 packs of Dragons and 2 packs of Fate Reforged. Unfortunately, it is a relatively bomb-driven set, rare-driven set, I should say. Alright, I have a Wooded Foothills, Jungle Hollow as my dual lands. I have 2 Monuments, Harbinger of the Hunt as a super powerful gold card. I see Rally the Ancestors and Secure the Waste. Secure the Waste being a bomb, Rally the Ancestors relatively unplayable. And looks like some pretty deep white here. Triple Mist Hoofkeer, and this is just a great bread and butter sealed deck card, like a solid, well-priced evasion creature. And yeah, Mastery of the Unseen. So I have 2 bombs in white in addition to just good depth, solid creature base. So white's going to be a color I strongly consider. Blue has not that much appealing. Aven Surveyor is a good card, but no single card that really makes me want to play blue. The High Priest can be good in combination with the right cards. Merciless Executioner, Ukud, Cobra, Vulturous Aven. Black is also not great, but is fine. Let's take a look at red. Twin Bolt, Calcisma Behemoth, Outrider, Summit Prowler. Descent of the Dragons ranges from like pretty good to a bomb, depending on what the rest of your deck looks like. But it will be a card I consider. I also have Harbinger of the Hunts and Wooded Foothills in if I want to go red-green or like Naya, something like that. Let's take a look at green. Obscuring Aether is fine. Looks like in green I just have... My green's just exactly medium. I have some solid creatures, but no bombs, really. So the colors I really like are white and then red, but especially red if I'm able to play red-green for Harbinger of the Hunt. So let me just put my my playable Naya cards down here and see what shapes up. I guess I'll just put pretty much everything that's playable, and then I can cut cards after. Arcan's Triumph, I would likely only play if I play the Harbinger of the Hunt. Alright, now I definitely don't want to play a 3 colors equal deck. I just don't have the fixing for that. I don't even have any of the green mana fixers like Map the Wastes or Sheltered Eyrie, I think the other one, the new one is called. Obscuring Aether, not great. Alright, now the next thing I'm going to do is pull out the non-creatures just to get a look at what my mana curve is looking like. In fact, I like to split the non-creatures between removal and non-removal, because your removal spells you pretty much want as many as you can get, and your non-removal you want to be more selective with. Return to the Earth and Pinion Feast, an effect that's not necessarily that great in draft, but I usually do like to main deck one in sealed because the dragons are the real bombs, and you want to have answers to them. So, as I was kind of hinting at before, I think I need to make my deck either white, red, splash, green, or white, green, splash, red. Or, I mean, potentially, I could just not play the white, but I do have two really, really strong late-game cards that make me want to play the white. Also, Secure the Waste and Descent of the Dragons is pretty nice. Let's say, for the sake of argument, that I was to just play white, red, splashing green for Harbinger of the Hunt. And, you know, possibly an off-color morph or something. The cards that I would really miss here are pretty much just Whisper of the Wilds. The rest are pretty good creatures, but they're like replacement level. And I can still board in a Return to the Earth even off the splash when it's very important to do so. Probably not that interested in these combat tricks. Maybe the Artful Maneuver, probably not the Center Soul. I only have one real bomb creature that's worth protecting. I don't like Drimoka Dunecaster. That's okay. Jeskai Barricade is good against people with pacifisms, but not super strong card in general. So this is shaping up to be an okay deck. Yeah. It's pretty good. I'm light on removal, but I really didn't get much removal in any of my colors. I'm going to have to depend on boarding in Surge of Righteousness and Return to the Earth and stuff like that. So my last cut would be probably the Dunecaster, the Dragonlord Servant, the Jeskai Barricade, Dragon Bell Monk. Do I want to play 18 or... I guess I want to play 18 lands with the Mastery being a great mana sink and the Secure the Waste and everything. Bowmasters is okay. Alright, so we'll call this option number one. Now, I still have 12 minutes left, and I intend to use it as much as I need it. So let's see what the deck would look like as white-green splashing the Harbinger. Probably wouldn't play both Return to the Earth and Pinion Feast in the main deck. I don't think I like this deck as much. I lose out on Twin Bolt and Descent of the Dragons as really powerful cards. And this is just kind of like a mindless, dumb creature deck, which can win sometimes in sealed deck, but really, you know, like, I'm leaning on these combat tricks, which I don't like to do. I have not very many non-creature spells. Just not a very exciting deck. I like the white-red splash-green version better. And I think if I was to give up on white, I would just reduce the power level of my deck by too much, the Mastery and the Secure the Waste, and the triple Miss Hoof Kieran too. So, I think I'm going to go with plan A here. Ooh. I wish I didn't do that. I have to remember what red cards I was playing. I'm deciding if I want to play the Dragon Bell Monk, so let me actually look at how many total non-creature cards I have. Descent of the Dragons doesn't really count for triggering prowess on Dragon Bell Monk. Yeah, it's pretty bad. I don't want to main phase Secure the Wastes very much, so I just have too few ways to trigger the Dragon Bell Monk. Now, are there any other cards I could possibly play with here? I'm intending to play two forests. So that's not really enough to play any of these medium quality mono green cards. Although I do feel fine playing the morph, just, you know, a good morph that I can play on turn three, unmorphs for single green. Not bad at all. I could play a Center Soul, a Kindled Fury. 16 creatures is about where I want to be. I mean, I could play 15 and feel good about it. Otherwise, I could add Dragon Bell Monk, Great Horn, Krushok. Don't really want to do that. Erishin Cleric might be okay. I guess my deck's sort of aggressive sometimes. Yeah, I think this is the configuration I want. Gonna add probably a pretty even split of plains and mountains with two forests. Yeah, two forests, eight plains. With the wooded foothills, it makes it roughly even between red and green. Or red and white, I mean. Alright, and then the last thing, I'm gonna take a screenshot in case I need to look back. Before I submit, let's just take one last look, just make sure I'm not missing anything in black or blue. I would love to play with the Cobra. The Grim Contest is okay. Mind Rot, Merciless Executioner. I don't even have the really strong exploit theme to make the High Priest and the Merciless Executioner good. And then blue really just has a couple flyers, but it's very, very shallow and not good. So I feel good about this configuration that I have laid out here. Hopefully the Master of the Unseen, the Secure of the Wastes, and my two dragon cards will carry me in the late game, plus maybe stealing some games just curving out and having a artful maneuver and flyers and stuff. So yeah, a good deck with decent mana, good creature base, and a couple bombs. I'm lacking in removal, but you can't always have it all. So I'm pretty happy with this. I'm going to submit. I'll pause the video, and I'll be back for round one.